Hello friends, I am Shweta Singh, Assistant Professor, Biani Girls College. I welcome you all on behalf of Guru KPU. The topic that I am going to deliver today is about hypersensitivity, or in normal terms that we call as allergy. So let's talk about that particular term, what allergy is and how it occurs, what is the exact mechanism that occurs inside our body. As I have classified this allergy into two main groups, first is humoral and second is cell-mediated hypersensitivity. Humoral, as we all know, humoral means it is contained in the blood, and cell-mediated means it is present in the cells. Mechanism, it actually occurs in the cell and it affects the other cells of our body. So in case of humoral hypersensitivity, it is of three kinds: type 1, type 2 and type 3. Talking about type 1 hypersensitivity, in this case mainly the antibodies that occurs or that comes at the site of inflammation are IgE antibodies. They are present on the cells, those are called as the mast cells, basically basophils. So they are present on the surface of basophils. When an allergen, it comes with its Fc receptor, that Fc receptor will bind with the Fc region which is present in the antibody. And then what happens? The cross-linking between the Ig molecules, it occurs, and this causes the release of the granules which are present inside the mast cells. Now these granules, when they will go to the other side of our body, again they will cause inflammation. So this can be localized, it can be systematic. Now one important term that I would like to tell you is about atopy. What atopy is? Atopy, it is the hereditary predisposition of these IgE molecules, means which are already present inside our body, means which are present from the birth. So that is called as atopy. Now the next type is about type 2, which is caused, which is in which the effector molecules are IgE, IgG and IgM. What these antibody do, they will activate the complement system, and due to which what happens, there will be a pore formation, pores will form in the membrane of the cells, and then the cell, they will burst. So this will cause inflammation. Two major conditions in which this type of hypersensitivity can occur, they may be transfusion, when the blood transfusion it occurs, or it can be a hemolytic anemia or hemolytic death that is concerned with the Rh factor of the mother and the fetus. The third type is about type 3 hypersensitivity, and that is because of the deposition of antigen and antibody so at some site. These sites can be the blood vessels or synovial membrane of the joints. Into these places, when this type of complexes are formed and when they will deposit, they will cause this type of third type of hypersensitivity. Now talking about the last, that is fourth type of hypersensitivity, another name which is being given for this hypersensitivity is called as delayed hypersensitivity. Why delayed? Because cells, they will take time for the proliferation and then they will cause the immediate effect, or then they will try to save the other cells of our body. So in this, what happens? The effector molecules which are produced, they are cytokines. These cytokines are produced by the TH cells. TH cells are produced along with the MH class, MHC1. Then cytokines, when they will produce, they will form macrophages. The main important work of macrophages, and they will try to eliminate that particular antigen out of our body. So the major organisms that may cause this type of hypersensitivity, they may be Mycobacterium tuberculosis, Leishmania species and Candida species. So these species are mainly responsible for this type of hypersensitivity. Under certain cases, what happens, this type of hypersensitivity, it may be very much deleterious for our body, and they may cause some granular formation that may affect the other cells of our body. So this is all about the types of hypersensitivity. For more details, you can log on to our website www.gurukpo.com. Thank you, and thank you.